Good evening, everyone. My name is Heath Haskins, Code Primate, and this is Mummy McSpringy. Good evening, Mummy.
Hi. Hello. How are we? Oh, I hear a sniffle.
Yes. So, dear. We both have come down with the colds, the coughs, and the sniffles. So this is going to be the sickest collab ever.
Yes. The sickest collab ever. And probably the one that you will want to watch over and over and over again, because it's just going to be so sick.
So sick. Sick Ollie.
Sick Ollie. Not sick Ollie.
Not a sick Ollie.
Not so, a sick Ollie.
Instead of having to concentrate or do anything big and heavy, we're going to go just on a Lumberland tour. So,
oh, yes.
When you first start, this is the res area, or the spawn plates. The spawn plates are right in here. So, do you want to explain like what this main little area is?
Yes. Well, this is the main biome in Lumberland, and right where my door is are some spawn plates that every time you die or reset, well, if you've got your base out, you reset on your base, but if you don't, this is where you reset right here. cough, cough. And it's the reason why it's right outside Wood Arras is because this is the very first place you will need to go in and learn about the game through.
Purchase your axes. This is
This
is the main store with Mr. Tom. Tom's your main man for all axe needs, conveyors, and stuff like that. So don't forget to pick up your blueprints as well. That's how you're going to build your base. So
that's right. When you pass through the doors, it will tell you everything you need to know for the first time. Then on the side of the building.
From here. Oh, right there. There we go. Right here's the wood drop off. This is where you start dropping off wood. You're not going to be able to process it at first because you're going to have to buy a sawmill and all that. But this is where you're going to make your first little bits of money so you can get better axes and go and buy land. And that's where we'll head to next.
Yes.
The Lumberland Tour.
Oh, yeah. Normally we'd be singing carpool karaoke right now, but neither of us have voices.
Hello from the other side. Sorry.
I think I coughed 1,000 times.
My sniffles. Sorry. Yes, it's the land store. Oh man, I'm so distracted. Like my head's all cloggy just trying to think where we're going to next. The land store is where you're going to purchase your first little bit of land, and it's going to just be a 12 by 12 by 12 square. So, I mean, it's really not
big. Yeah, and also, it's only going to cost you 100 the very first time you buy your first plot of land. Nice and cheap.
Here, I'm going to zoom out as much as I can. There are a total of 9 slots. Is that right? 9 slots?
Yeah, 9 base plates, yeah, that you can choose from.
This is my favorite one. Stay off this one. But here's the first one, and then they'll go around clockwise as you select which one you want to spawn into whenever you're doing loads and saves. We'll just hit each one of these along the way.
It used to be my favorite one right there. When you're starting out, it's nice to be close to the wood drop-off.
I like this one when I'm doing rookie runs, like whenever I go to do rookies. I haven't done a run in a long time, though. Here. And then here's my favorite one for when I'm doing blue maze runs, right here.
Yeah.
And here's this one. And then it goes
this across is fully
this one.
Yeah.
Sorry, go ahead.
Yours is fully expanded. Mine has got a few spaces left in it, as you can see.
We decided not to load in the big hoss of a base yet because we were doing a tour and running all over the place. So
you wouldn't be able to see anything if we did that.
Ooh, what was that? Hold on. Ooh.
What was it?
Because I'm just far enough away, there's a huge, like, one of the walls disappeared, so I can see into the mountain. That was pretty cool.
Cool. Speaking of a mountain.
Let's go up this direction a little bit. Here's the notorious half circle cave. There's nothing behind it yet, and I think there was a plan to do something with it, but if you happen to see it, you know where it's at. It's right diagonal from the Wood R Us store. This is a nice little cove to come whenever you're getting your first sets of oak wood and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Should we go this way or the mountain first?
Yeah, that's Oh, how long is the bridge going to be down? Should we go the other way?
Yeah.
The rock bridge.
Let's do the rock bridge first.
All right. Sniffle, here's a tissue for your issue.
No, I took medicines and stuff about 15 minutes prior to this recording. That way it would have a chance to take effect. That way I'm not as bad as I normally am. It's really bad.
Oh, that's good.
It was so bad today.
Wow.
So, as you can see, we just came this direction up the mountain, or up the road. This turns into the mountain pass. This pass leads up to the volcano. Oh, and birchwood. Birch.
Yes, birchwood.
I'm going to turn up my
sound. It's a really, really nice wood.
Just a little bit. Settings. Oh.
Oh,
sorry, I was paying attention to the menus and not so this is a good spot for like grabbing birch. Birch.
Yeah, actually the music changes in every area, so
mm-hmm.
I'll just put the music up because I haven't got it up at the moment. All the way. Might just be able to hear it on my recording. You hear the sound of the engine.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is the rock bridge, and normally this is not down. What you'll have to do is you'll have to go up to the top of the volcano, come down the side, and then jump behind there, and you're supposed to use TNT. We did find a way that you can push it off by using a truck and your doors and like a whole bunch of time. It's about 8 to 10 minutes if you get good at it. So, here, let me back up. We'll actually make a run up to the volcano. So here's the volcano entrance. Right here. Mummy, you ready to go?
Yep. Halfway through, there's going to be a change that happens. Halfway through this tunnel. About here. There we go.
And now we
are... So the trick...
Sorry, go ahead.
The trick to this is keep to the left and keep going up without stopping as fast as you can. Don't stop for anything. And that'll get you up and get you avoiding those big boulders coming down.
And don't take trailers, Laser.
Don't take trailers.
And here's
lava
the
trees.
Lava trees, firewood, redwood. It goes by many names, but this is the most coveted thing right here. This is going to get you the most money the fastest, and that's because the trees are so big. You're going to need a Solmax 2 just to get the big pieces to go through. Oh, excuse me. I'm about to sneeze. Maybe not. Okay.
And a great view of a Lumberland from up here as well.
Mm-hmm. When you chop down these trees, try not to take them back down to the volcano. Just drop them off right here, like down this little corner, and
yeah,
they'll fall down there. You'll be good. Let's show if I can do this. There we go. Right about here is where you jump off, and the rock bridge is right down there. Right here.
Normally sits there, and it's actually just collapsed, by the way. So we have to bring it down again.
Oh no. Did it? It's not respawned.
Yep. It will respawn once those boulders clear. It takes another amount of time. But that's okay.
We should have gone to the swamp first.
Yeah.
Alright. Is your life full?
Yes, very full.
Alright. Here we go. By the way, this is also where me, Siniak, and Midget did the race.
Ah, yes. Even with a trailer at one point. Oh my gosh.
Tell them about the green box path.
Oh, yes. Now, that is just here, and there's a bit of an obby to get to it.
Uh-oh.
We're kind of stuck. Oh, no. Don't fall off.
Okay.
Yeah, there we go. We're safe.
Sweet.
You need to long plank across lava to get to the white box that glows green.
The white box.
And your success will be noted.
Hmm.
Well, so we can't get through there at the moment.
No. That bridge is how you get over to the swamp area where you can get zombie wood and gold wood. And you know what? I think we'll just do some long planking to it.
That's a good plan.
It'll be easier. So. There is
Yay!
A backside to the mountain where you can go down and get to the snowy biome. But we'll show you where that's at as well. Pick up some dynamite over there.
Yeah.
Lumberland Tours, now open all winter season long.
Yeah, there's loads of tourists in the back with their cameras out taking photos.
Bunch of people from Phantom Forces coming over here to visit for the winter.
Yeah. Awesome.
Oh, Cherry Grove. Is it Grove or Co? Or?
Cherry Meadow, I think it's called. But it's beautiful. I wish there was a base plate here that we could just like have your house up here. That would be awesome.
So
it's so nice.
Here's where the cherry blossoms are. And the cherry wood is really good for building like furniture and things.
So yeah, it looks
so
really
walnut.
Cool.
Walnut's really good. But this is a little grove of cherry. Sorry, go ahead.
Mind doing a cherry road. That'd look cool. Cherry and birch road.
That would be cool. Let's shoot across. We'll put the bridge down and do a tour over there real quick. Grab some dynamite. We'll come back, and once we have dynamite, we'll long plank up. I forgot how big this place is.
Good plan. That is so big. Must have taken so long to actually piece it all together.
Mm-hmm.
But then some biomes were added on later, so.
This is Saranok. He's the first toll bridge.
You'll also notice that there is a little round kind of hole in the glass. That is so that you can get to the end times biome underneath the bridge.
With the ostrich eye.
Yes.
Just to the left here, you'll notice a hole in the river. That is the river tunnel. Yes, you can get inside of it if you drive a car down and like, there's a trick to it. There's other videos on it. And then here's Merrily. He's our second toll bridger. Hey, Merrily.
Yep. Hello, Merrily.
Have we ever tried putting a eyeball on that side?
I've done it. Yeah, it's the same.
Gotcha.
Same result.
We're now in the, hold on, what is this called?
The savannah?
Safari.
Safari.
Safari is one of the many areas of the biomes of Lumberland. This area contains three stores and a lush forest with varieties of ... by the way, this is, all this information is also on the Wikia page. Shout out to the Lumber Tycoon 2 Wikia. Jerex has got it locked down over there. Good job, Jerex. So here's Fancy Furnishings, and they're actually open really late. What's going on? Boxed Cars is already closed down. Anyhow, there they go. They just closed. So this is where you can come and buy furnitures and toilets and beds and cabinets and all kinds of good things.
Yep. All sorts of stuff. And I mean, I use so much glass. So much.
Here's where you can buy boxed cars. This is where you can get the utility two, the truck, and both sets of trailers, the small and the large. Prices can be found on the Wikia page.
Oh, yes.
Walnut wood. Excuse me. Hold on 1 second. Oh.
Walnut wood is very dark brown wood. Very, very versatile for building. Looks good.
Sorry about that, guys.
It's all good.
We also have elm that grows over here. Cherry that grows over here. And then up in this little grove right here, this is the safari hole. And this is actually the exit to the maze. When you're down inside the maze, you'll see a hole up in the wall. If you go up there and drop stuff down, it appears over here. And the same thing, if you jump into it, you will come out over here. Now, the end times, if you know what we're talking about, we haven't gotten there yet. End times actually has a hole that's covered by wood, which is supposed to end up that same spot. Correct?
Yes, I heard that too. That it drops down into this as a exit in case the bridge goes up. Actually, this is a theory I haven't tested yet. How about paying for the shortest amount of time for the bridge, getting yourself stuck down in the end times biome, letting the bridge go all the way up, and seeing if that plate opens up?
I've done it, and you die. Once the bridge is up, you take damage.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
Now, I did this at nighttime, so I don't know if there's a difference between the day and the night, but it did damage.
Wow.
We're just taking that first right off the road. Here's Bob's shack. Hello, Bob.
Hello, Bob.
Good old TNT
Bob. We need
Bob.
The dynamite.
Mm-hmm. So, I'll grab one, you grab one.
Also, you can get jelly worms here, which you need for the rookie quest.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we forgot to say the light bulb is at Fancy Furnishings. You gotta buy it from Corey.
Yep. I'll just whitelist you, actually. I don't know if I have.
Oh, yeah.
And probably don't want to whitelist me after me being the Oathbreaker.
Oh, good. You now have a toilet on your tree, too.
Perfect.
Mummy was picking up logic across the way, and we'll show you where that's at. But while she was across, I moved her toilet out of her bathroom onto the top of her tree. So this is the backside of the safari area, and this happens to be one of the first shortcuts I ever found or ever got told about, and it was how to take a tree, chop it down, cut off its limbs, throw it up here, and then go up there to get your gold wood. I did that for about 2 weeks, and then I found out how to long plank.
It was quite easy, just chop a tree and lean it, and then jump parkour across a tree.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Oh man, the noob days, when I was so new.
Oh yeah, the good old days. Back when people used to actually haze you in the game and try to rip you off and hack and cheat and exploit and bully and all that other stuff. Those were the days.
Nowadays, they come into the server and they're like, I'm going to scam somebody. Oh my gosh, it's Code Primate. Hello.
Yeah, it doesn't happen anymore. That's not to say you should attempt it, because I'm pretty good at trolling you back. I must warn you. No, do that. I love everybody.
Me too. I love all my fans. Awesome. I love the people that aren't my fans. The ones that are like, you're old. I'm like, oh, I love you too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's park this for a second. Now, I already have a long plank. Oh, I don't know that I'm going to use that one. Ugh. All right. Let's go ahead and grab this one here. Is this long enough? Should be fine. Okay. So we're going to long plank up the mountain for just a second.
So you have to lift up the plank and then move forward and then lift it up again and move it and then keep moving it till you get there.
Yeah, I've gotten pretty fast at it. Oops, missed. Hold on. Oh. Bragging about myself. Bad. And then I jack it up. Yeah, let's move up a little bit. Why not? Turn sideways like this. There we go. Long planking takes forever.
Zoop. There you go.
If you don't know what long planking is, that's what we just did right there. It's where you set your sawmill down, you grab a trunk of an elm tree, which are the large trees right there. Throw it through, and you get these humongous planks. Now, the way to do a long plank is you look up in the sky, and then you can turn with it. If you don't look up in the sky, it's almost impossible to turn. We're just going to go straight up the mountain. There we go.
Woohoo! Da-doink!
Your poor voice. Woohoo!
I can't tell woohoo. Can't tell woohoo. Can't do anything.
We gotta be over there, don't we? Oh, I'm on the wrong side. So we're right above where the half circle is.
Oh.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Cough, cough.
Here's the floating rock.
This is a floating rock. It actually isn't. If you look right down to ground level, and you can see that it doesn't actually touch the ground. Oops. So it's jammed in there. See?
And up she Ba-dunk. Goes. Our music.
And the music's changed.
Yep, I was about to say the music should be changing any moment now. Do 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 do. There we go. Perfect.
Yay.
Okay, so let's see if I can zoom out here. I can't zoom out far enough. Anyhow, the rock bridge leads to this little area up here, comes down, and leads to the top of this area where you have to go across to that side. Hang tight one second. Back over to that side, go down another little ramp, and then it comes right around here and into here. And this is the swamp cave. We don't need a long plank over there, so. But as we walk through the cave, oh, it's taking forever. This is going to be like the longest video ever. The sickest collab ever. Sick.
Sickest collab. Sick collab. Oh my gosh. So sick.
So sick.
Wow.
There we are.
So look at it. Isn't it beautiful?
Zombies and the gold.
Zombie wood, gold wood, and the pink rock.
Now, I will still, to this day, say that the gold wood is the fastest wood to gain money off of if you long plank with only two long planks and if you have a quad saw to just throw it straight in. There is no stopping. Like, you go... Go ahead.
You actually don't need to quad saw it. As long as it's on your base, it will not despawn until the server or you die. It won't despawn. So you just need to get it to your base.
Yeah, but then it's the chop time and all that.
But yeah.
There was one day I spent... Oh, sorry. There was one day I spent... It was just... I had about 10 golden gold trees. That's all I did is I just ran, dropped them all off, and by the time I was done, like, the quad saw had already chopped it all up. It's pretty good.
Wow, that's good.
So, and then if you follow it on through, like if you follow the water path on through, on the backside, there's a path that leads down to that little area that we were just at. So, that's the tour of that side. And this is the swampy area.
I love the swamp area.
It's got creepy music. I don't like the creepy
music.
It's
so creepy. Sniffle, sniffle. Croak, croak.
I was really determining on whether I should record or should I just get rest, and I'm like, no, I can't break my daily streak. No.
No. We could maybe do this in two parts, like do a rookie run and the logic store and the maze in part two.
We could probably do that. But we've already got the TNT. We've got the TNT ready to go.
Do you have jelly worms? Do you have a light bulb? Do you have sand?
No. I don't have any of that. Alright. Grab this. Going down the mountains is much easier. Just look down and then, like, you can hold on to the plank. Oh, landed on my head.
I was actually trying to land right under you so that you'd have to drop on me. That's alright.
So real quick, watch this. I'm going to slide this. Maybe I'm going to slide this. Maybe not. Maybe I'm going to mess this up. Hold on. This is how we know that it's a floating rock.
Oh, you're going to try and get it to move. Then shift and S.
Oh, it's not moving. So maybe it's not a moving rock.
It's got a gap though. Big gap. All the way around.
There's a good distance there.
Have you tried blowing it up?
I have not. Ooh.
I wonder if there's anything behind it.
Oh. And I dropped my limb. There we go. Wait, are you...
I was on it.
Go for it.
It's on the end. Alright. Woohoo!
Lift, lift.
I'm flying, I'm flying. Oh my gosh. I can't find squeaky voice.
Gonna fly like a mummy to the sea.
I believe I can fly. Squeak. No singing for me. Check it out. It's working.
So are you still on there?
I'm still on there.
Alright, I'm gonna try and shift walk.
Whoa. I fell off when you did that. That was good though. I got quite far.
Alright, alley-oop.
Woohoo! Oh, we could be like a circus act.
Da, 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 da. Whoa!
Oh!
Ouch!
Ow!
Help! There we go.
That was funny.
A couple of sickly Robloxers running through. People are going to be watching this like, what are you doing?
Oh.
I don't want to drop it on there. I've got a bunch of blueprints for the laboratory. There we go. Alright, let's go to the snowy biome. Got your coat?
Yeah, I've got my nice winter sweater on.
Alright, I got short sleeves on. We're good.
You need to put on a nice warm coat.
Might have to go buy one. I heard Mummy makes a really good sweater.
Oh, yeah. I keep everything warm.
We forgot to tell everybody that that's the boat.
Oh, Hoover's boat is not there at the moment. There's a dock.
It is, but he's taken off on us.
Yeah, he's just left. You can see him leaving now. So. Bye, Hoover.
He's expensive. About 400 per trip.
400 there, 400 back. About 7.5 minutes, is it? 7 minutes.
Seven minutes apiece at each drop. So,
yeah.
If you're going,
2 minute travel time.
You're absolutely going to be spending 16 minutes. That's a given. Just for the trip. And then, additionally, you're going to spend $800 on whatever it is. It doesn't matter if you're getting a painting, if you're getting logic, if you're getting wires, neons, $800 minimum. Oh, wait. I'll hold on to my TNT. So the reason we picked up the TNT is because you have to take it over to the middle of the this little area. If you look, there's the road. There's Wood R Us. And there's a little area just behind here, behind the spawn plates, or the base plates. Come up the mountain, and there's a cove with rocks in it.
Code, is it just me, or is the bottom of this boulder glowing pink?
Okay. Where at?
Right here. The bottom edge of it. Maybe it's because it's against green. Maybe. Okay. Alright. So we're just going to throw a dynamite in here. And open the box. And I have to turn it around so the wick is upright. Then, you ready for detonation?
Yep, go ahead.
Alright, here we go. It's lit.
Close
and
my
we're
door.
Backing out.
Watch it. Got it. Nice.
I just avoided it, but like MacGyver and the explosion behind.
The explosion coming out behind you.
Yeah.
Oh. Pay attention, Code. There we go. So welcome to the snowy biome. I'm going to turn my volume down because I don't want to get hit for some kind of copyright craziness.
Hang on. Let me do the same.
Yeah, this is the biome this is Kevin McAlloy. It's a free song and you're going to get hit. My dispute is up on December 8th. So, and they can't dispute it. I mean, it's a free song. But anyhow. This is a snowy biome area all around. And if we come
so
down
nice.
To the very end. I know, the music is so great over here.
Yeah.
Come down here to the end. Oop. Right here. There's the red bird. This is the, this is where you come in
the
to
hatch.
Get the rookie. Oop, sorry.
Meet our friends.
This is the smuggler's den.
Yeah.
And you get them the three items. Go ahead, I'll let you explain.
All right, there are clues in Lumberland about who has what for dinner. So we've got Guzmanek, we've got, I actually can't remember the rest of their names, but they each have a specific item on their plate, and then from once you get it right, down will drop the rookie axe. You want to carry on?
during special events, the rookie axe won't be the rookie axe, such as last Halloween, it was the end times axe, and
which is this one right here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It was the same amount. The difference in between the rookie is...
This is the rookie.
Texture. Texture is the main difference. They're the exact same model, except the end times axe has a 2x faster swing. They do the exact same amount of damage.
Yeah.
Well, we can't really do it because we don't have a tree in front of us, but...
Yeah.
Also, if we look through the walls, this is not surrounded by anything. This is that gray box that is dropped from the ceiling. In that one video, that one time.
Yep.
So, all right.
There is a gap behind here as well. Quite a big gap, actually.
Wow. I don't see anything hidden, though.
No. No secrets. No, nothing hidden.
No secrets, nothing hidden. There we go. Alley-oop.
Alley-oop.
On with the tour. And then, if we head backwards here, this is the, what do they call this? The rock?
The snow arch.
Snow arch, yes.
Yep.
The snow arch right here. I don't know if this was a hot spot for spookwood or not, but there have been sightings here on top of these mountains.
Yes.
But that's only during the October time frame.
There's also another path right at the back of the snow biome.
Mm-hmm. Right here.
Right here.
If you look to the right, you can oversee all of the wintry biome, snowy biome.
Lovely.
Turn. There we go. If we keep going, do you want to tell them about the little gap up here?
There is a little secret little gap on the right. You can get down just here. There it is.
I do not recommend going down unless you have a way of adjusting your light. Maybe take a light with you, take a pumpkin with you, and a long plank, a medium long plank.
Yeah.
Because you're not going to get back out just by yourself. Spelunking in the winter biome.
Uh-huh.
And then here's a little path down. There's no little paths over there. So this comes up.
We can see the cove from here.
I can zoom out.
The ocean cove.
Right there. Now they called that the Snowy Peninsula right there. Whoops.
With this part here.
Right there. On the left.
Okay. Yeah.
I call it the cove. And I can't go too far on this side, but here's the end of the world. There we go. So there's...
That's the last point. The point of no return. You drop off, you die.
And dropping off the world does not lose your axes because it's considered a void kill. That's the void down there with nothingness. So.
However, who lost their axes trying to do that recently?
Is it programming? Might have been programming.
Yeah. Possibly.
Is that a little gap over there? Hold on.
It's a little shelf there.
It's nothing we can get to, though.
No.
Okay. Back around.
Such a large world, so much to do and explore. So many places to put cool things into it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wait, where am I going? Oh, I missed the ramp.
Left.
But this time of day? No, you need to take the 5. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
What are you doing?
Sorry, I forgot that there's a thing there. I'm sick. Leave me alone. All right. Push.
Nearly.
Push. Almost. One more. Let's both stand here. Push.
Yeah.
There it goes.
Oops.
Nope, still don't have enough room to...
I'm trying to jump under it.
Here, stand on my head. You're going to be the wedge at the back.
All right, okay. There we go.
And push. Nope.
Didn't work.
There it goes.
Oh, Nope. Try again.
Here. Can you stand on my head?
Wait, where's your head? Right. Oh.
Oh. There, I've got to scoot you a little bit closer.
Closer. Yep.
Push.
Ah, that helped. I think there that's doing it.
There it goes. Are the wheels all down?
Close the tailgate, it might work.
Yeah. It's close enough. Push. And one more. Push. Yay. And we're done.
Yay.
Put Benny Hill music right there. Sorry.
Yeah. Speed that up. Speed clip.
You know I don't edit, guys. Come on.
You're already at 40 minutes.
We are. It's going to be a good video. Anyhow.
Yeah. It's the thickest collab yet ever.
Longest collab. Everybody's probably asleep right now. If you're still watching it this time, put hashtag still watching. Love you guys for it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for putting up with two sick YouTubers.
Listen to our sniffles and coughs through the entire thing. Poor guys.
Yeah.
Oh, we don't need to. Oh, no. Should we run it?
Are they coming down again?
Yeah, they're coming down right
Wait.
Now. Should we run it? I'm going to run it.
Okay. Oh, no.
It was like Indiana Jones right there. That was awesome.
Wow. I've never seen him come down twice. That is so cool.
Well, there's only one more area to go and explore. Do you want to do it?
Oh, it depends. Go check to see how long it take for the boat.
That took us about the boat's 7 right there. Oh, let's just go.
The boat might be leaving shortly.
Don't leave, Hoover. Don't leave. Kaboom. Nailed it. when do you run next? 7 minutes. So he just arrived.
Oh, he just got here. Oh dear.
When do you run next? 7 minutes and 20 seconds. That's okay.
Oh no.
I'll go ahead and purchase a ticket. I'll buy a ticket. Ah, music changed. Boom, 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 boom.
And the sun is about to set, so logic will be just about to close.
Actually, it's just rising.
Oh, wait, it's rising. Mm-hmm. You're right. Oh, I've got myself turned around.
So the sun here's is rising. Here's the loading dock parking lot thingy. And what is this? This is the tropics, right?
Yep, tropics biome.
The snowy area is also known as the taiga biome.
Taiga. Yeah.
So over here, they got these big trees that I don't remember the name of. Koi?
Koa. Koa trees.
Koa trees. We got some birch trees. Yep. We're not going to buy any logic, but here. Take a quick tour of this, because this is one of my favorite stores to be in. There you go. Good morning, Link.
And it just opened.
Yay.
Yay.
Here's where you
all this lovely
neon wires.
Neon.
Let's mess this all up. Rawr.
And some of our favorite logic. Yeah, we use all of it.
Inverts and
inverters, love inverters,
or XOR. And if you want like the breakdown of what these do, we have other videos. These are delays, these are sustains.
Yeah,
wood detectors, lasers, laser detectors. There's plates, hatches, and then all this stuff you can get over at WoodRUs. the wires and stuff. So very good. Thank you, Link. Bye.
Thank you, Link. Bye.
Super weird. Now for the notorious cave.
Oh, yes.
Wait, is it closed off today? No, it's not a Wednesday. So on Wednesdays, it's closed. I think it's on Wednesday. Or it's like the last Wednesday of the month or something like that. do you know how to adjust your filters so you can see down there?
Yes, I do. I can just go to here.
All right, so Mummy had to leave on us. So I will be continuing the final part of the tour on my own. And as you can see, I've got my filters turned on. This is with OBS. There's the ability to add filters. So when you first come down, that's the long way down. It comes to this first little split. And I am going to run through this kind of quick just to give you a tour of what's down here. That first path right there that leads up to the split off. Oh, come on. So you can either go to the right, which leads to the back area, and it also leads up to, well, here. We'll go take a look at it real quick. That teleporter that we were telling you about earlier. Come on. So that way leads to the back area, and the teleporter area is right here. There we are. Oh, forgive me for the cold. This is absolutely horrible. But right here is the hole. Right there is the hole that leads to the safari area. So that's how you get back over to the safari. If you wanted to have somebody at this end dropping wood in there, you'd have to have some kind of plank or some kind of long plank to get the wood up there, drop it in. But you could work with a partner. That way you wouldn't have to pay for the bridge every single time, or pay for the toll bridge, not toll bridge, Hoover. Head back down this direction and take a left, take a right. There we are. Now this way, if you run all the way down here to the end, just kind of follow it around right here. And it's going to hook around. There's going to be two lefts. We should be able to see door number one. All right, there's door number one, and it's closed. Oh, and my lights aren't on. There we go, lights. So this is door number one. That's just a dead end. I will turn. There we go. Take this straight down. This will turn to the left, then to the right. Turns into like a little Y section. We're going to go off to the right, and this turns into a U section. At the bottom of the U, we take another right here. And this is going to be door number three, right there. Door number two should be right there. So that's door number one, two, and three, all closed. We'll back up all the way down this. This will lead back to the beginning, right here. Take a right. Right there's the beginning, and this is the main little hallway type thingy. Same thing up there and to the right. That's the beginning. That's the split. So we'll take this down. We're gonna go to the right. We're gonna check doors number four and five. Just go straight across right here. Don't try and go down there, because that's a whole bunch of mess. You'll find some people lost down in there, but door number five, no, that's door number four. And door number, oh, I can't see it from here. Door number five, So 4 and 5 are closed. Oh, oh, oh. Come back around. Almost got myself lost there. Did you see that? Oh, that was scary. Now number 6 and number 7 are right here. So number 6 is open. Number 7 is closed. So I'm just going to take number 6 in. Oh no. 6 is closed. Alright, so 6 and 7 are both closed. And that's it. That's the final little bit was the cave, and it seems to be blocked off today. I'd love to take you down there for the cave crawler wood, but as you can see, it's not an option today. Oh shoot, where did I go? Oh, there we go. Okay. Got turned around a little bit. Oh, there is one final place that we have not covered. And that, oh, oh, that, let's see, 1, 2, 3, gonna go left, and a right. And left. And that is the paint shop. Hello. Yay. And the paint shop will be the final one. Let's go to our game capture, set up the filters. Remove that. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. There we go. Very good. So I do apologize about the length of the video. I should be able to cut out most of it, a lot of it. We'll do some time lapses in there, but thank you everyone for watching this episode of Lumber Tycoon 2, the Lumberland Tour. And, oh wait, do they have the painting? Okay, they do have the painting. I'll go ahead and pick myself up one of the little water paintings while I'm down here. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. I will leave links in the descriptions. Go check out Mummy's channel and like and subscribe to her as well. Thank you guys so much for everything that you've done for me. Sorry about being sick. I love you. Have a great night. Bye.